bit nervous, excited. First time to meet you guys.
Please,
have you seen? Come on, I mean, you've been like in the business so much longer than I was. Ich meine, ey, natürlich muss ich nervös sein. Die sind wesentlich länger in dem Business gewesen als ich. And now you're back. Well, not back. You've never really been gone, actually. So, first of all, I have to ask, this is not the entire group. There are like three missing. Where are they at? Why are they?
They're back in LA waiting for us to get back so we can shoot our new video.
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
We've been doing a press tour. We were in Tokyo, Paris, Amsterdam, London, Cologne, and now Berlin's our last city.
But it must have been kind of the same picture all the time. Like, people, oh, they're back. Even the guy who brought the water was like, wait a minute, wasn't that? Yeah, it's been them. So even he was excited seeing you guys. But let me quickly translate that.
Sorry.
Yeah, just be comfortable. That's what we expect. But you know, that for example is quite unusual. Ich meine, dass wir sowas haben, das hat man heutzutage bei Rockbands. But seriously, you're actually a classic rock band. Something like that would never happen with the new ones. Like the ones like of not judging their music, but like Limp Bizkit and Linkin Park. They seem so much calmer next to you. Would you agree or is it?
Well, they're definitely different. I mean, I've seen some Limp Bizkit shows and they don't necessarily seem calm. It seemed like a lot of energy. But what we do is very sort of raw rock and roll kind of, you know, it's very earthy kind of in your face, different kind of thing. We just very pure.
It's definitely more of, it's a primal thing, and we have this chemistry that's been there since basically day one. We started playing together almost, you know, 20 years ago. And the difference is that, like, I think probably people feed off of this chemistry. It's not a thrown together band. I mean, we took a while to put this whole thing together, finding the right guys. Yeah. We had the core slash Matt and I. And
wait, first of all, okay. I try to say that segment before I'm just going to forget all of it. Also, that was actually my first question. I mean, there are like three possibilities why you actually been back together, especially the three of you. Either it's business, either it's friendship, or even it's family, I would even
Money's
say.
Never coming into this equation.
But no. You said it's family, or is it still a friendship?
No, the thing that brought us back together, really, was the death of a friend. We went, a great drummer who played for Ozzy Osbourne and Lita Ford and all these other bands, one of the true rock and roll drummers of our generation, passed away in 2002 of throat cancer. So I was at his funeral, and there's all these musicians there, and I ran into Matt Sorum, and so he goes, well, there's going to be a fundraiser for Randy's family in about a week, and everybody's going to get together and play, and it's going to be at the Key Club. It's going to be an open, big, huge event. And so he says, well, you want to play? I said, yeah, what are we going to do? We'll put together a small set. Let's call Duff. That's what brought us together.
That was the first gig.
I was in Seattle going to school, getting my finance degree. I had a band loaded. I was still playing music, of course, but when they called to come down and play, it was like, okay, sure, I'll come down and play. And the moment we got in the same room the day before the gig for rehearsal,
it was just overwhelming.
It was very overwhelming. My knees buckled, you know. We'd had great bands, you know, separately, and the passion was still there, you know. But that chemistry, we'd sort of forgotten about it. It had been 7 or 8 years since we really played together.
Yeah, plus having left...
Again, please let me translate. Because, you know, yeah. We just would like to have a little throwback. I know you're having a new band and like the past is one thing, but just for your former fans or still your fans, I think they really appreciate just to have a little glimpse on an old school video of yours.
And I'll dispel any rumor or whatever. I mean, we're very proud of the legacy we left with Guns N' Roses. Yeah. So
we don't downplay it.
And because most of the time it's like, can we talk about it?
But well, it's been a long time.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
Now at this point, we might have been bitter when we first left because it was under the circumstances, it wasn't a pleasant time. But we'll always be proud of the actual band that we started from the gutter and brought to
So let's have a look with some pride. Ich meine, Sie können jetzt schon stolz darauf sein, jetzt mit ein bisschen Abstand sehen das ein bisschen anders. Am Anfang noch etwas verbittert gewesen, aber jetzt guckt man da zurück.
From the gutter, say from the gutter.
From the gutter?
Yeah.
In which sense?
In the sense we are street artists.
Homeless, moneyless.
Ach so, also so. Wir sind schon immer noch bei mir. Slash und Duff von Velvet Revolver. Ja, Velvet Revolver, nicht Guns N' Roses. Das ist passé. Wobei, wir sind mal auf der Straße gewesen, beziehungsweise auf einer kleinen Party und haben ein paar Prominente gefragt. Wollt mal wissen, so, was wisst ihr noch über Guns N' Roses? You know, we've just been around on some parties, been asking people, do you remember Guns N' Roses? What was your memory with it? And we met a German singer and please have a look what he said, weil wir haben jetzt Ben getroffen und der hat sich als Guns N' Roses Fan geoutet. Hört mal selbst.
Ja, also ich fand Axl Rose immer schon sehr geil. Ich hatte zwei Plakate in meinem Zimmer hängen. Einmal, als ich Okay.
What did he say?
Well, he said something like that he had, like, the posters of Axl Rose, that he was really a huge fan of it. But there was, like, one particular thing that I was, like, kind of surprised, because he said his favorite song was Bed of Roses. And I had a look at it. Maybe we should look at it together, because... Schauen wir uns mal bitte Bed of Roses an, den Lieblings Guns N' Roses Song von Ben. Okay, also sollte Ben ja zuschauen, weil Ben ist ja wirklich ein netter junger Mann. Gerade bestätigt, ist es doch ein Bon Jovi Song. Also es ist Bed of Roses, kein Guns N' Roses Song.
There you go, that's live TV for you.
Exactly. Temple Pilots. I mean, I just kind of described the influence that I heard from you, like from that what is saying about your music, but in your own words, what is it that actually fans of all these bands that are gonna expect from that album? Contraband.
Well, it's definitely its own thing. I mean, the combination of the five guys, there's no better five guys on this planet that could have made up this band. And it wasn't planned or put together, slash explained how we got together. Found Dave Kushner, he was playing in my band Loaded. He was the perfect guitar player for this band. There's not many guitar players that can play with Slash, just because of the way he plays, the passion he plays with. He's just kind of overwhelming. Dave stepped in and really just took his own place and owned it.
Mm-hmm.
And Stone Temple Pilots broke up. Scott and I were friends. Our wives and I were really good. Our wives were really good friends.
I mean, does it mean that all your projects are actually kind of done now that you are...
We dropped everything when we started this. And what to expect from this is just really something different. Not exactly what you'd expect, but definitely high energy, definitely loud, definitely in your face. It's definitely very expressive, it's very musical, but it's just at high velocity.
Mm-hmm.
There's all different types of songs. It really runs a whole gamut for us, but you really just need to listen to the record and you definitely need to see the band live.
Can we expect any ballads? Because when Metallica came out, they just left them totally out. What about you guys?
We have slow songs.
Oh, you have slow songs. Okay, so let me translate the entire package. Wow, it's a bit... Revolver.
It's purely unbridled fuck you rock and roll again. You know, it's dangerous. Anything could happen any night.
Also, fuck you rock and roll ist gefährlich, ist auf jeden Fall live harder, because I think she's really impatiently just to talk to you. Tanja aus Koblenz habe ich jetzt am Apparat, ist das richtig?
Ja, hi.
Hi, Tanja.
Hey.
Rock and roll.
Hey, rock and roll.
Kleiner Fan von Velvet Revolver?
Bitte?
Ein kleiner Fan von Velvet Revolver?
Sorry, aber eher von Guns N' Roses.
Eher von Guns N' Roses, she's rather... Okay, da musst du aber das neue Material immer anhören von Velvet Revolver. Wenn es dann rauskommt am 18.05., it's gonna come out on the 18th of May, your album, Contraband.
The single.
Yeah.
Okay, Tanja.
Actually, the single goes to radio next Monday, April 5th, and single comes out in May, and then the record comes out June 7th.
Okay. Yeah. Also, im 7. Juni kommt das Cover für uns.
Yeah.
She
won
it?
No, she didn't want it. She just gonna win it if she recognized
a song
that Slash would play. Das Ding ist gar nicht. Slash wird jetzt was kurz was anspielen, so 30 Sekunden lang, und wenn du es errätst, dann kriegst du diesen Game Boy Advance SP. Ist das ein Deal?
So, if you don't win it, I'm gonna take it home.
Now we're gonna perhaps give, like, viewers another chance, but we can talk about it. I got connections, we can talk about it. Good. Yeah, sure. So, Slash, would you...
Yeah, so I should do
please
this, yeah.
Give us...
Yeah. All right. I don't know.
An idea of that track. Hören, aber Tanja, nur als Tipp, es muss nicht unbedingt ein Guns N' Roses, noch nicht mal ein Velvet Revolver Song halt sein.
Ja, Also es tut mir furchtbar leid. Ich habe so gut wie nichts erkannt, weil es doch ziemlich gescheppert hat in der Leitung. Also nichts gegen Flash, hat sich wahrscheinlich voll geil angehört, aber in der Leitung habe ich sehr, sehr wenig verstanden.
Wie machen wir das denn? Ich rufe mal schnell in den Raum, weil das ist ja auch, ja, wie machen wir das jetzt? Hat sie trotzdem verloren? Tja, ne?
Take a guess.
Okay, you have to decide, because the problem she definitely, it's not to diss you in any way. Okay, not 30 seconds. It's not to diss you in any way, but she didn't hear that much on the phone. So what should we do?
It's on the phone?
Yeah.
I'll play it quieter.
No, I think we just have like 20 seconds, actually.
Okay, it's an AC/DC song.
It's an AC/DC song, so actually she didn't make it. Die können Sie noch drin lassen? Okay, gut, hervorragend, great. Wir haben gerade gehört, wir dürfen Sie doch noch... Aber kein Problem, you know... Actually, we just decided we're just gonna give her. First of all, I'm gonna break it and then we're gonna leave it to her.
Yeah,
we should do it.
Yeah,
right?
Just give it to her anyway. Yeah.
Okay, du kriegst das Ding einfach so.
Hey, danke schön.
That on the phone.
True.
That's impossible.
No, I thought maybe she's watching television, you know, and Dolby Surround, HGTV and all that. Aber den kriegst du auf jeden Fall, Tanja, und wenn du noch eine Frage hast, dann kannst du sie selbstverständlich stellen.
I wouldn't have taken your Game Boy, Tanja. I wouldn't have taken it.
No, also er hätte mir eh nicht weggenommen.
Wenn ich seinen Bass bekomme, kann er auch meinen Game Boy haben.
Wenn du was?
Wenn ich seinen Bass bekomme, kann er meinen Gameboy haben.
Sein Bass? Well, she would trade it in for your bass. But I got a GameCube at home, I would trade it in too.
No,
ich würde einen GameCube gegen tauschen. Aber okay, deine Frage.
Ja, ich würde gerne wissen, ob es im amerikanischen Fernsehen so eine Art Promi-Boxen gibt und wenn ja...
Do you have the same type of show as we have, like where you have like popular people who like boxing against each other, like presenters, yeah, singers and stuff? But if you would have this kind of a show, who would you like to fight against?
I would, you know, the only thing that really comes to mind is anybody who fucked with my family. I would have no problem with killing somebody and going to jail for the rest of my life if somebody fucked with my kids or my wife.
I can agree that. Well, I totally dig that. But I wouldn't have said that. Well, okay, no. You truth, it's... Also definitiv, ich kann ihn verstehen.
In other words, he's saying, you know, fucking keep yourselves at bay. You don't want to fuck with them.
Yeah, that's what I... Yeah.
But I, you know, I don't have any animosity against somebody, like, I want to go fight them, you know?
Also, es ist jetzt nicht so, dass sie sich drum reißen und von nachvollziehen, dann gibt es richtig Ärger.
What about professionally, though?
Professionally?
Yeah, well, who do you want to fight professionally?
Yeah.
Professionally.
Slash, frag mal nach.
Try to put you on the spot.
Well, I kickbox. I kickbox 5 days a week. It's like one of the best kickboxers in the world. So, but I don't kickbox professionally.
Okay.
But I train with guys.
But none of the popular people has been like professionals. Just like for the entertainment aspect. That's why you can pick.
No, I fight with real fighters. Like I'm a sparring partner for guys who are getting ready for fights and stuff. So I'll fight like I'll watch a tape of a guy they're fighting, and I'll fight the fight that their opponent would be fighting.
Also im Endeffekt. Im
T-Shirts, Konzertkarten. Ich bin.
Tanja, ich verstehe. You see, that's what I mean. You just came here. And she just like told us like what she'd been like all the concerts. And this right now, just talking to you is like the holiest day right after the birth of her children.
Wow.
You know.
Really?
So just to give you an impression, what you actually cause when you come in Iran here. But Tanja.
Yeah.
Ich danke dir.
Kann man kriegen.
Is it possible just to write some autographs for her then later?
Yeah.
We'll write it on her Game Boy.
Genau.
Ja, genau.
Schreib's da drauf, okay?
Ja.
Dann ist
und
halt noch
ich wollte noch jeweils ein Autogramm separat für meine beste Freundin, die auch so verdammt.
Tanja, das kann ich jetzt.
Ciao.
Danke.
Because what I wanted to do is like just have the questions from the people on the streets. We've been asking people and that's the question I wanted to ask you.
Hi Jungs und so, ich wollte euch mal fragen, habt ihr eigentlich noch Kontakt mit Axel?
Yeah, of course. That question had to come. Is it that you're still in touch with Axel somehow?
No. It's all about Velvet Revolver now, and it has been. I mean, since the days we left GNR, I mean, for all intents and purposes, that was the end,
We spent our entire, actually teenage to adult lives putting together a band and making a band that went from nowhere to becoming superstar band. Mm-hmm. And he sort of single-handedly ended it, so we were pretty pissed off. So we haven't talked to him since, you know, no reason to.
Ja, so Fakt ist, sie haben keinen Kontakt mehr mit... Waren sie schon ein bisschen pissed, also kein Kontakt mehr.
Although, you know, we've never, that's the most pissed off I've ever heard Slash say. We've never aired our dirty laundry, you know, in the press or anything about.
Okay, so I don't want to push you. I don't want to push you because I respect that you're here as Velvet Revolver, right? Ich meine, ich respektiere das, dass sie... And we have a caller who would like to talk to Velvet Revolver.
Okay.
Wir haben einen Anrufer, der gerne mit Velvet Revolver sprechen würde. Hallo?
Hallo?
Wen habe ich dran?
Easy aus Hamburg.
Hallo, Easy aus Hamburg.
Ich hätte gern gewusst, wann Sie denn, ob Sie auf Konzerttour kommen nach Deutschland und ob Sie auch in Hamburg spielen.
Yeah, of course. You're going to release an album. What about the tour? Are you going to also come over to Germany, especially Hamburg?
Yeah, we could be here as soon as June.
Already?
We're going to start touring, hopefully, May 7th in the States and do festivals, and if we do festivals here, we'll also do clubs in the city.
Right, and also when we're going to do an extensive tour of Europe and Germany included. Yeah. Also, when we get the whole tour sort of as it keeps going. Mm-hmm. So yeah, you can definitely expect.
We must reclaim Germany.
Yeah, don't worry. I think this is going to work. So on, all right. Also, she would love you to play like in a little. Are you actually play like in small venues?
We're going to. Yeah, we you know we've learned a couple things. Throughout all these years, and one of them is how to keep a band together. Mm. And another one is, even if we get to the status of playing arenas and stuff, we're gonna play small clubs in those same cities, because there's nothing like being this close to your audience and getting that feed. Mm. Now, you play festivals, sometimes you're 50 yards away from the front yard, from the front row. So.
And to keep it more fun, you got to break it up. You got to do it all.
Yeah. Okay. Also, natürlich ist es. Oh, that's about it. Seriously, you know, you just came after years back here to Germany, and then in June, when are you gonna be back with the album? I hope that we will have like so much more time, and then we will be able to listen to your album and see the video.
Yeah.
That was very changed. So thank you so much.
Okay.
It was an honor for me.
Thanks, Patrice.
Nice talking to you.
Thank you so much. Von Velvet Revolver. Wie gesagt, wir werden sie hoffentlich dieses Jahr nochmal haben. Und jetzt gibt es Abschied. It's up to you just to pick the last video.
Oh, we got The Strokes' Reptilia.
There you go. Thank you so much.
All right.
Velvet Revolver, man, here.